Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to make our website mobile responsive using CSS media queries. Now, in earlier videos in this series, we had already worked on the responsiveness of the navigation bar and the horizontal slider. So if you reduce the width of our browser, you're going to notice that the navigation bar and the horizontal slider are going to be responsive, which means they're going to fit well on mobile devices. However, if you scroll down to other sections of the website, specifically the recent post section as well as the footer under it, you're going to notice that these sections are just messy. And that is because we haven't worked on the responsiveness of these sections. So that is what we are going to do in this video. And to give you an idea of how this website is going to look once we have worked on it and made it responsive, let's go to the finished project and give you a perspective so that you can see how the website is going to look when we are finished making it responsive. So I have scrolled down to the recent post section, and if you begin reducing the width of the browser, just study the contents in the page very closely, you're going to see that it's going to be responding to the width of the browser. Notice the size of the margins in the page, and as we reduce the width of the screen, you're going to notice that at one point the margins are going to reduce and the content is going to move in and fill those spaces. And if we continue reducing even further, at one point the sidebar is going to disappear and then it will be sent down here. Meanwhile, the posts here are going to extend and fill up the entire width. So this is what we call responsiveness. As the width of the screen is changing, the contents in the website are responding to that change. Before I reduce it further, I want you to draw your attention to the footer also. At this point, we have already stacked up the three main sections of our footer vertically. Remember, they were horizontal on the large screen. So back to our recent post section, if we continue reducing the width of the screen even further, you're going to notice that at one point the contents of each post are going to be stacked up vertically. As you can see, the image is on top, followed by the title, the post info, description, and the read more button, which now covers the entire width. So this is how your website is going to look on a mobile device, and this is how by the end of this video we are going to transform this project we are working on to look like the finished project. And now just in case you don't yet know anything about CSS media queries. Well, media queries are just some instructions that you define, some CSS instructions. For example, here it says that when the screen of the device that is accessing our website is 750 pixels or lower, then make these changes to the interface. So, for example, consider the navigation menu. When the width of the screen is 750 pixels or lower, the width, which was maybe 60% or so, is going to be 100%. And this is it. So if we reduce the screen and we go beyond 750 pixels, below 750 pixels, you're going to notice that this navigation menu is now covering the entire width of the page. And that is the change that occurred in this media query. So that's basically it about media queries. And when you go outside of that 750 pixels range, you're going to see that the navigation menu takes maybe 50% or so, and that is the normal dimension we had given it for large screens. So we are going to be doing something similar. We are going to write specific instructions for the different screen sizes. And to know the width of your page, it is very simple. Let's go back to the project we are working on. We right click anywhere and take the inspect option. Then we click on the toggle button here to toggle the device. Okay. So now if you notice here, you're going to see the responsive option, and then this is the width and this is the height. So you can now vary the width of the device. You can now vary the width of the device. And when you reach a point where you want to make any changes, like here for instance, you're just going to copy the width here, create a media query, and provide instructions on how the page should respond to this width. So let's drag it back out and start making our changes from scratch. So this is how our website is going to be displayed on a device with a width of 1287 pixels. Now it doesn't need any CSS queries because it looks okay as it is. Now we can start reducing the width of the browser. We reduce, and again at this level there is no problem, our content still looks great. So we can continue reducing further. And at this point, we see that our content is beginning to overlap. So what we are going to do is we are going to write a CSS media query at this level to extend the content, the width of this content in the middle, so that it occupies this space and makes more room for the content inside the post. So we are going to define a CSS media query at a width of 934. So back in our CSS file, we are going to just copy this to define another CSS query. This time it's going to be at 934 pixels, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, 934. And what do we want to happen at this width? We want the content to fill the entire space, like to fill up this margin. And all of this is wrapped inside a content div. Let me just indicate that by putting a border around content div. So we scroll to the section where we've written the style for content, and I'm just going to place a red border on the content. If we refresh the page, we are going to see that this is only filling 90% of the page and is leaving 10% to go for nothing. Now that we are running out of space, we want to fill this space. So what we are going to do is, at a width of 934 pixels or lower, we want to make the content to have the entire width. So we go back to our code, we copy the CSS for that content, and we scroll down to our newly created CSS media query. Inside this media query, paste our content. We don't want to change anything except the width, and we want that width to change from 90% to 100%. And when we do that and refresh, we're going to notice that at this width or loop, our content is stretching and filling the entire width. And when it stretches like that, it's going to make it less overlapping. So we continue reducing again, and everything still looks okay, except at this level where it's beginning to overlap again, specifically at 835. So at this level again, we want to make another change. And this time there is no margin for us to fill. What we are going to do is we are going to send the sidebar to the bottom, and then the main content here will fill the entire width. So let me give the sidebar and the main content a border so that we can identify them. So this is the main content that covers the recent posts. I'm just going to give it a blue border. And then the other section is the sidebar. So I scroll down to the section where I've written the style for the sidebar, which is right here. And I'm just going to give it a green border. so that we can identify the two. We refresh it and we see our main content with a blue border and then our sidebar with a green border. We see that our green border ends here and the content inside it overflows. That is because we gave it a specific height, which is a mistake on our part. We're going to let it extend and enclose everything inside it. So I'm just going to go back to the CSS and remove that height. So when I remove this height, the container is going to extend and cover everything that is in it. To refresh, and this is our sidebar. Okay, now we have identified the contents we want to change. Now let's go and copy them, place them inside our media query, and write the styling for the changes. So the first thing we are interested in is the main content itself, and we want it to cover the entire width. So I'm going to copy the styling for the main content. I scroll down to the media query and I paste it under the content. The only thing I want to change is the width, and I want to give it a width of 100%. So when I go back to the page and refresh, you're going to see that our main content, that is in blue border, is going to fill the entire width. And this is our sidebar. Initially, our sidebar was given a width of, a width of 30%, but now that we have sent it down, we want it to have a width of 100%. So I'm going to copy the styling for the sidebar as well. And then inside the media queries, I'm going to change the width to 100%. So when we do this, head back to our browser and refresh, it looks okay. The only thing is I want to reduce the margin on top of the search section here. So to do that, I'll go back to the code, scroll to the styling for the search section that is inside our sidebar. Okay, search section. So I'm going to copy the styling for that section, scroll down inside that same media query, and I'm going to reduce the margin at the top to about 30 pixels so that there isn't much space here. We'll refresh and that looks better. So now I'm going to remove all the borders so that our content can be clean. So I come up here, I remove the green border, the sidebar. Up here again, I remove the blue border of the main content, and then the red border also of the content. Back in our page, we refresh, and our website looks good now. The sidebar is a bit too close to the edges of the screen, so I'm just going to give it a padding. So I'll scroll down to that media query that we defined. Scroll down, down, down. And inside here, I'm going to give the sidebar a padding of 10 pixels this time. We'll scroll, go back to the web page and refresh. And it looks better now. But I want this also to have, I want the main content also to have the same padding so that it looks more accurate. So I'll go back and inside main content, I'm going to do the same thing. I'll give it a padding of 10 pixels. This doesn't go. And I understand why this doesn't go. That is because each of our posts already has a margin at the corner. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select each of the posts. I scroll up to the content section. This is the content section. Then I select the styling for each individual post. Let me just select everything. I scroll down again to that media query. And just under the main contents, I'm going to paste this. Okay, I want to make the width of each individual post to be 100% as well. Yes, the height is just going to be maintained. The margin, give a margin at the top of 20 pixels and photo, that remains unchanged. The border radius remains 5 pixels, the background is white. Okay, yeah, so it was not even the border, it was not even the margin of the post, it was the width of the post. So we needed to give each post a width of 100%. I'm just going to move this up. So when we give each post a width of 100%, it's going to fill the entire width of the main content, and then we can give it a padding of 10 pixels just like we did with the sidebar. We go back to our page and refresh, and you're going to see now that they are well aligned. So this is it. This is it for the present post section, but this is not yet all. But because our video is getting very long already, I'm going to end this section here, and the next section we are going to finish up with the responsiveness of the recent post section as well as the footer. So thank you guys for watching, and hopefully I'll see you in the next section.